Hello, you awesome possums. Daily missions weren't always as generous with certs as they are now. Fortunately, they changed it up a bit, so now you can get about 300 per day as a free-to-play player, which is quite a lot compared to what it was. So I have a couple of things that would make this just a bit faster. Just a bit, because not everyone has the best stuff, the time, nor the skill set of pro players, like myself. Because Bill Gates once said, "I choose a lazy person to do a hard job, because a lazy person will find an easy way to do it." Did I just quote Bill Gates in a Planetside 2 video? Huh. Number 1. Getting the kills. This one's straightforward for all class missions. But like I said, some players aren't particularly good in getting kills. For this one, you're gonna want to find a big battle because at some point there will be some sort of a stalemate or a choke point which could last a few good minutes. This normally happens in a room or a cave entrance or a tight hallway. And you will see everyone piling up waiting for a chance to take a shot at someone. You'll be surprised how often this happens. This is where you come in. You grab your frag grenade, charge in like an angry Karen in Starbucks, and toss that motherfucker in. With any luck, you will get a good chunk of kills. If you have the spare certs, you can get the grenade bandolier to increase your grenade capacity, which will also help you with future daily missions and would even make it faster. Just want to remind you though, the certainty of death is real with this method. This is a cheese way to do it, I know, but if you just want to get it done, it works. You will get those kills faster than a stripper could reject a call from her daddy. Well, depends on what kind of daddy we're talking about here, but you get the point. Number 2. Motion Detect XP. For this one, we're gonna use method number 1 to make this faster. Instead of chucking in a frag grenade, you're gonna have to shoot your recon dart. But don't just shoot it anywhere. Make sure that dart is on the ceiling, above your enemies. However, be mindful because the darts are easily destroyed. It would likely be destroyed by a single grenade explosion. Luckily, you can spam this because ammo will be all over the floor in these kind of fights. This way, enemies are all close together and you can complete the mission in no time. I find this easier than sneaking behind enemy lines or No Nut November. Number 3. Heal or Shield XP. Okay, healing 30 people shouldn't be that hard, so why is this here? Well, you're not the only one trying to out-heal Jesus in this game, so sometimes it'll take a bit longer than expected. For this one, you guessed it, we're still using method number 1. This is a no-brainer, just hop into the action and use your class ability and it should be finished fairly quick. However, if you have the spare certs, you can once again invest in the grenade bandolier or healing grenade. This way your heals will cover a wider area which will make those numbers stick faster, so you have more time browsing Riley Reed's Instagram page. Huh. She seems nice. Before we proceed, just want to say I appreciate the support with the last couple of videos because it helped grow the channel a bit. That being said, if you're enjoying the video, please leave a like and subscribe because this will really help the channel. Lastly, we have vehicle damage. This is one of the weird ones. Some say it takes 2 or 3 shots from your rocket launcher for the hit to register. Which is sometimes true, sometimes not, I'm not really sure. If you know the actual number of hits, let us know in the comments. Anyway, out of all the class missions, I think this takes the longest to complete without using other means. So as an alternative, you might want to hop onto a tank or a turret, as I find this method relatively faster compared to using your starting rocket launcher. Once again, if you have the spare certs, you might want to get a rocket launcher with lock-on capabilities and target ESFs instead. I swear, I'm starting to sound like a salesman or something. I personally use the NSR-3 Swarm. This is quite effective, especially when there's a ton of aerial vehicles up top and you're shooting from a safe distance. Okay, so I didn't include the other missions as those are really easy to get, like aerial damage, hacking terminals, repairing or reviving. Hell, there's no shortage of dead bodies in Planetside 2. And that is it for this video. If you have a different way of doing the missions faster, leave it in the comments below. Sharing is caring. Once again, thanks for the support, happy holidays, and I will see you in the next one. Stay safe and stay awesome, Possum.